इसमें स्क्रीन इज विजिबल। नो सर, नाउ
यस सर।
ओके, सो इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द ओएसआई मॉडल, राइट? सो दैट इफ वी रिवाइज देन वी हैव discuss the last four layer, right? Like what is the functionality and what is the application of this layer, right? And then at the last we have seen the advantages and disadvantages, like the OSI model is kind of a hypothesis, right? So ideal and this complete model is not accepted by any manufacturer, like some part we are using, and the reason is like there are many layers which have the same type of functionality, right? Like flow control, error control, right? These are some example, like this thing or somewhere the addressing. So these are some common functionalities done by many layers, so because of that it may affect the data rate or the speed of the communication, right? So today we'll see for the IP address. This IP address, it's like logical address, right? When we have discussed the OSI model at that time, we have discussed like there are two types of address. One is a physical address and the second is the IP address. So the physical address is generally given by this NIC network interface card, and the second one is the logical address that is given by the protocol, that is IP, right? And the name is that address, the IP address also. So logical address, IP address, both are the same thing. So an IP address represent a unique address that distinguishes any device on the internet, right? So generally you need this IP address when you are using the internet, right? So that will give a unique name, right, to your device. So this IP means internet protocol. It's define the set of the commands, direct the set up of data transfer through the internet or any other local network, right? So an IP address is an identifier that enables your device to send or receive data packets across the internet. So it's work as a identifier. This IP address holds the information related to your location, and because of the information of your location, right? The two-way communication between the devices, right, is possible. The internet requires a process of distinguishing between the different networks, routers, and websites, and therefore IP address provides the mechanism of doing that, right? So it forms an indispensable part in the working of internet, right? And you will observe, if you have seen the IP address, then it has the numerical value, right? So each IP address is generally made of 32 bit, right? Its length is 32 bit, right? And this 32 bit, right, generally it is given by the decimal value. So you can see here in the example, like 93.32.216.9. So this kind of a dot decimal notation, right? And you can see like there are four numerical value which are separated by a dot, right? So that dot, so you can say like it's in the notation you separate the actually each value or each number, it's 8 bit. So you have four different value, four numbers, so 8 plus 8 plus 8 plus 8, so total 32 bits, right? So it's actually 32 bit, but when we will see for you it's in the form of decimal number, and those are separated by the dot or point, right? So here this example, these 93s represent the decimal notation, right? And it is first 8 bit, and that where the second the point 32, so the 32 represents the second 8 bit, then 216 again it's represent again 8 bit, and the last 9 digit, right, that is also represented by 8 bit, right? So such way this IP address is made, right? So they are expressed in the form of four pairs, right, where each value, right, is ranging from 0 to 255. So here you will see the number like 198, 32, 216 and 9. So these numbers will vary from 0 to 255. Why they are vary from 0 to 255? Maybe you are a civil engineering student, or maybe you don't have the subject digital electronics. So in digital electronics, like in the digital means you have two values, 0 and 1. That is digit. So whatever the bit, whenever we talk about the bit, those bit are in the form of 0 or 1. So 2 bit, so here each value is of 8 bit, so 2 raised to 8. So bit is generally 0 or 1, only two types of bit are there. So you can say like two values, right? And now this IP address, right, the IP address is of 32 bit, and this 32 bit in the form of like 8 bit you have represent, then dot, again 8 bit, dot 8 bit, dot 8 bit, so total 32 bit. Now this 8 bit, so 8 bit means it will be a combination of 0 and 1, right? It will be in the some different combination like 0001 1110 1010 10, like that, all ones, all zero. So total how many combination you can create? The 0 and 1 means two value, and you have that kind of 8 bit, so 2 raised to 8. So 2 raised to 8 means you have 256 different combination of 0 and 1, right? So this 256 combination, so that value it will convert into decimal, then it will be from 0 to 255, right? Different 256 different value. So 0 to 250 might means it is again 256 value, right? So it means this all 8 bit, right, in the decimal form it will be from 0 to 255, right? Now you got it, right? So that's why, right, here all the this four pair, so four this value, which is separated by dot, are ranging from 0 to 255, right? Okay, and this IP address, this value, right, these values, these bits are not randomly produced, right? They are generated mathematically and are assigned by authority which is IANA, Internet Assigned Number Authority, which is a department of ICANN. So ICANN stands for the Internet Corporation for Assigned Number and Names and Number. So it's a non-profit corporation founded in US in 1998, right? And its main aim is to manage the internet security, and it will enable it to available for all or available by all. So for example, here you can see in the figure, like you have a router, and with that router you have three different LAN, local area network. So in that three LAN, for example, in LAN 1 you have three computer connected, its names are A, B and C, and in LAN 2 you have two devices that are, for example, will give the name D and T, the computer name D and E. And in LAN 3 again you have two computer connected, and those are F and G. So this A to G, A B C D E F G, these are the name of the devices. It may be computer, it may be mobile, it may be laptop, any devices. So here example of network, you have a single router, with that router you have connected three LAN, right? In first LAN you have three devices, in second LAN you have two devices, in the third LAN you have two devices. Now you can see, like in the below each devices there is IP address is written, like 223, right? 0.1.1.1 223.1.1.2, right? Likewise, right? So now this IP address also has some subclasses, like based on this, how you will give the name or how you will define this bit. Based on that, it has five different subclasses. So before discussing that, if you just observe this figure, right? So here you can see this IP address, like 223, the first part or first 8 bit or first value is same for all PC. Then the second digit is 1111, that is also common in all the 7 PC, right? But if you see the third digit after dot, like in the ABC it is 1, in DE it's 2, in FG it is 3. And if you see the last digit, right? So that last digit you can see, like in the first LAN it is 123, for A it's 1, for B it's 2, for C it's 3. For LAN 2, in LAN 2, for the PC D it's 1, for E it's 2. In LAN 3, for F it is 1, and for G it's 2. So you can see this second last digit, right? It's changing based on the LAN. So for LAN 1 it's 1, for LAN 2 it's 2, and for LAN 3 it's 3. And if you see the last digit, it is also varying in a particular LAN. In LAN 1 it is changing, like in LAN 1 you will not find the same number at last value, right? Like last value is not same in LAN 1, like here 1 2 3, all three are different. But if you compare this LAN 1 and LAN 2, then the last digit or last value, like for A it's 1 and for D it's also 1. So this last value is local to particular LAN only, right? So for two different LAN you may have the same number, right? So that is our observation of this particular figure, right? So here in IP address, you can say like this 32 bits, total 32 bits, which are will give by 4 decimal number, different decimal number separated by dot, right? These 32 bits are divided into two parts. One, the first part that is made of the first 24 bit, or we can say first four decimal means the first value dot, second value dot, third value, is first three, right? So that first three value are specify the network, and the second part, which is of last 8 bit, right, that will specify the host, right? So here is first 24 bit or first 3, right? Also in computer language, 8 bit is equal to 1 byte. So that's why here it's written first 3 byte. Right? So this first 3, it is used for specify your network, and the last one is for to specify or to identify the host. The host means your device. Okay. So as I told, like, this IP address, right, can be categorized in sub classes, right? So total 5 different classes are there, right? Class A, class B, class D, and class E, right? Don't confuse with these ABCD, right? These are the name of the computer I have given, ABCD. But here, these are the class name, class A, class B, class C, class D, and class E, right? So let's see, like, in each class, or how each class will define, or how will identify each class. So like first three class, right, that is used in the LAN and WAN, right? So when we have the LAN network, local area network, or the wide area network, right? So that used in that we will use this class ABC. And this remaining two class, which are, you can say, like, not widely used, or you can say it's used for research and development purpose. So D class is reserved for multi-classing, and this E class is reserved for research and development. So it's application of use, right? So I have mentioned here all the five class. So, like, you can see, like, on the top, it is written byte 1, byte 2, byte 3, and byte 4. So actually, byte 1 means first 8 bit, byte 2 means second 8 bit, byte 3 means third 8 bit, and byte 4 means last 8 bit, right? So this IP address is divided into two parts, network ID and host ID. So in class A, you can see, for network ID, only first 8 bit or first byte is used for network ID, and remaining 3 byte. 3 byte means 8 bit, 8 bit, 8 bit. So total 24 bit for host ID to identify the host. Right? In the class B, you can see, like, instead of byte, single byte, 2 bytes means 16 bit we are used to identify network, and remaining 16 bit we are using identify for host. and class 3 was 3 byte means 8 plus 8 plus 8, so total 24 bits we are using to identify network, or we can use as a network ID. And the last byte or last 8 bit will be used for host ID, right? So network ID, it represents the number of network, and host ID, it will represent the number of host. So definitely if you have 1 byte means you have less number. If you have 2 byte means you have total 16 bits. 16 bits means how many numbers? In digital, whenever somebody asks you for the number, you just have to use the formula 2 power whatever the number of bit. So 2 byte means 16 bit, so 2 raised to 16 number, right? So that we'll see in the detail, but you have to remember just in class 1, class A, class B, class C, right? What is the difference? The difference in the portion of the 32 bit, like how many bits we are used for network identification and how many bits we are using for host identification, right? So class 8 bit for network, 24 bit for host. In class B, 16 bit for network and 16 bit for host. In class C, 24 bit for network and last 8 bit for host, right? And this D and E, these are the multi-class addresses, and E is for research and development. So each class has a specific range of IP addresses, and the class of IP addresses is determined by the number of bit used in the class, and the number of network and number of available host in that class, right? So in the class A, total how many bit you have for IP address? 32 bit. So among the 32 bit, the first bit, starting from left side, the first bit must be 0. That's why it's written here 0. And the remaining 7 bit, using remaining 7 bit, you can identify the network. Right? And this is first bit, that is 0 plus 7 bit for network. So 8 bit you have used. So how many bits you have remain? 24 bit. So that 24 bit you will use for host ID. So as you can see here, 24 bit are used for to identify or to give the number of host. So 24 is the large number of bit. So that's why you can say this in class A, right? These IP addresses assigned to the network that need large number of host. If you in your network, so actually this is automatically done by your system or by your network administrator, right? When you connect your the device, your PC, laptop, right, in some network, this address, IP address, is itself by default it will define, right? For example, in your network, let's take this example. This week, right? So in LAN 1 right now, ABC 3 device is connected. Now for example, if you connect the fourth device with this LAN 1, then automatically it will assign the number except this last digit 1 2 3, may assign 4 5 6 7, whatever, but it will be different from this ABC, right? The first three bit will be first three value will remain same, but this last value 1 2 3, newer device will take any value, this last value except this 1 2 3, right? So except this 3, it can take any value which is between 0 to 255, right? So here in class A, right, you have 24 bit. So 24 bit means how many address you can can take using 24 bit, right? 2 raised to 4, 24. So if you find 2 raised to 24, that much of amount or that much of number you can give to the host, means devices. So based on your network, how many devices you have connected, according to that, automatically your system will take class A IP addresses, or it may be class B IP addresses, or it may take the class C IP address. Right? That is based on the number of connected devices, right? Or how many number of devices you want to connect. So, right? So here you can see the network ID you have. 0 is fixed bit and 7 bit, so total 8 bit you are used for network ID and 24 bit you are using for host ID, right? So here in class A, the first bit in higher order bit of the first octet is always set to 0, right? As I told, so the higher order means from left side, the first bit is always set to 0, right? So remaining 7 bit determine the network ID and the last 24 bit determine the host ID in the network. So here 7 bit for network ID, so total how many network address you will get? 2 raised to 7, so 2 raised to 7 is nothing but 128, right? So total 128 network address, right, can be used in class A. And if you want to find the number of host total in class A, then again you have 2 raised to 24. So 2 raised to 24, right? And there are things here you will write, here they have written 2 raised to 24 minus 2, and that you will get the number like 1677214. So it's about like 324. So 167 left, right? So approximate that much of device, that much of computer you can connect in a network, and you can give the different name, right? And here they have subtracted 2 from 2 raised to 24. Here 2 they have subtracted for a specific address they are using for a specific purpose. So that's why the 2 address, the 2 value, right, we cannot use for a local computer or a local client, we can say, right? So that's why they have subtract the 2 from 2 raised to 24, right? But approximately you can say like 2 raised to 24 devices they will use, right? You will find 2 raised to 24, you will get approximate this 1677214 value, right? So that is about 167 left. Then we can talk about class B. Then in class B, again the first 2 bit are fixed, right? And that is 01, okay? Here the 16 bit we are using for network ID, and 16 bit we are used for host ID. So for 16 bit, in which first 2 are fixed, means 01, so we now have 14 bit only. So 14 bit means 2 raised to 14. So 2 raised to 14 is about 16384. 16384. So that much of that many network address you can use in class B type, right? And you can talk about the host addresses, then you have 16 bits, so 2 raised to 16. Again, we will not use 2 addresses, so we will subtract 2 from that value, so you approximately you will get some 65,534, that much of address or that much of host you can address using this class B category. So that much of IP address you have.
Then in class C,
right? In class 3, the first 24 bit you are used for network ID, and the last 8 bit you are used for host ID. Right? And in 24 bit, which you use for network ID, in that the first 3 bit you will use as a 110. So you will see out of 24, 3 bits are fixed, so you have now 21 bit remaining. So 21 bit means 2 raised to 21 is about 2097152. So that much of different network address you can assign, right, using this class C IP addresses. And if you talk about the number of total hosts which you can connect, so that is you have 8 bit for host ID, so 2 raised to 8, right? It's about 256, but 2 address we are not using, so 2 raised to 8 minus 2, so it's about 254. So if you use class C type of IP address, then you can only connect 254 computers. So for example, in your network, in your office, in your home, if you have a number of PC which is less than 254, then definitely you can use this class 6. But if you want to connect more than 254 computer, also just you will increase a single number, that is 255, then also you can't use this class C type IP address, right? You have to use class B or class A. Okay? So based on the number of PC, the number of computer, the number of node you want to connect in a network, you will use, or your network automatically will use class A, class B, or class C. Okay? Then class D, in class D, right? As I told, it's for research purpose or it's for multi classing, right? So or multi-class, so this IP address is reserved for multi-class address, right? This does not possess any subnetting, right? Or subnet, right? And here the first four higher bit, right, are fixed, and that is 1110. So now you have total remain 28 bit out of 32 bit. So remaining this 28 bit will determine the host ID. So you can connect with 2 raised to 28, that much of number host, right, when you will use this class B IP addressing. Now in the class E, so in class E, the again similar to class B, right? Here the first 4 bit are 1110. Here it is all 1. Right? So all first 4, the higher 4 bit are 1. So out of 32 bit, 4 bit are fixed. So now you have only 28 bit. So the 28 bit means 2 raised to 28. That much of host or that much of PC you can connect with your network. So here you can see you have only facility of host ID in D and E, right? But in ABC you have also the facility of network ID. So this network ID is generally, this network ID is given by your router. So here you can see in this example I have router. So the you can see like this third second class value, right? So in len 3 is 3, len 2 is 2, and len 1 is 1. So that is given by this router. So you can call it like its network ID. So in class ABC you have the facility of network ID, but in B and E you only have the host ID, you don't have any network ID, right? So here is the complete table, like in class A, B, C, D, E, right? What is the value of higher bit, right? The fixed value of higher bit, as we have discussed in A, first higher bit is 0. In class B you have the first higher bit is 1 and second is 0. In C you have a fixed higher bit is 110. In D it's 1110, and in the E it's 1111. Then the network ID, so in class A first 8 bit, in which 0 is fixed, so you have remaining 7 bit that are used for network ID. In class B you have 16 bit, in which 2 bits are fixed, so remaining 14 bit you will use for network ID. So that's why you can see here in A it is here 8, but in the column like number of network it is 2 raised to 7. Why 2 raised to 7? Here 8 bit for network, but still it is 7. Why? Because the first bit is fixed, that's why we are not included. Same way for class B, 16 bit are used for network ID, but here we will write the number of network in which we write 2 raised to 14 only, right? Because two first two bits are fixed 10, right? So similar way for class C, you have 24 bit for network ID, but first three are fixed, so remaining 21 you can use to find the number of networks, which 2 raised to 21. And in class A you have 24 bit for host ID, so you have 2 raised to 24 number of host. And for class B you have 16 bit for host ID, so 2 raised to 16, that much of number of hosts you can connect. And for class C you have 8 bit, so 2 raised to 8 host you can connect, right? And in that two addresses are reserved, so you can use like 2 raised to 24 minus 2, 2 raised to 16 minus 2, and 2 raised to 8 minus 2, right? So if you using this information, if I will give you the range like in which we will represent the IP address, so for class A the IP address will be start from 0.0.0.0 to 127.255.255.255, right? So here you can see like the last value will be changing from 0 to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to 255, same way 0, second last 0 will be also changing from 0 to 255. Likewise, all the value will be ranging from 0 to 255 except the first value will range from 0 to 127 for class A. For class B, right, the last three part can be vary from 0 to 255, but the first value will vary from 128 to 191, right? And for class C, similar way, the last three value will be ranging from 0 to 255, but first value will vary from 192 to 223, right? And class D and class E, right, that is from 224.000 to 239.255.255.255, right? And class E will range from 240.000 to 255.255.255.255, right? So these are the range of IP addresses. Now for example, if in your PC you in your office or in your laptop, if you want to find the IP address, then how you can find? So if you are using the Windows operating system, then in Windows also, like I'm using Windows 7, but some of you maybe using Windows 8 or Windows 10, right? So like here you can go to search of search window, like in my case if I click on the start button, then here I can option of search. So if you write cmd means I need to open the command prompt. So if I open it, right? So see here, if I write like IP, I need to write IP config, right? Without any space or any character, right? Or any dot, comma, anything else, right? So if I just enter, then you will see it's providing me the many information. But here, the top side, you will see like it is showing me this IPv4 address, right? So that is 192.168.193.92. So this is the IP address of my laptop, right? Which right now I'm using. So same way, you can find the IP address of your device, right? You can see here also you have four part, right? And that is separated by dot, right? So that way you can, right? You just need to write in command prompt IP config without any space or any special character, right? So you will get the IP address, right? If you are using Mac or some laptop or a laptop of Apple, then you go to the system preference and you can, if you click on the network option, then it will show you the IP address, right? So here in this figure you can see like 192.168.0.31. So this is about IP address. In IP address also, the type like static IP, dynamic IP, right? But we'll not go much detail, right? There is information like what is IP. Still, I will share the notes about like all other types of IP addresses, okay? So we'll stop here. In the next class, we'll see like proxy and the subnet and firewall, right? So that we'll see in the next class. Anybody have any doubt in today's discussion?
No, sir.
So we'll stop.